Stardom is a thing that is very difficult to define, although I suppose if you're treated with a certain amount of regard, people start needing to put labels on you, and star is sometimes used. The star sort of suggests people living in grand houses with swimming pools in Beverly Hills. In fact, it's just damned hard work most of the time.
And that work takes its toll. With a broken marriage behind him, Tom Allen has now established a new relationship and a more settled home base. But travel and separation add to the other inevitable pressures.
I did think that things would start to get easy with experience and the nerves would disappear. In fact, it gets worse because so much more is expected of you every time you go out there. You also expect so much more of yourself. You're looking for something more. You're trying to perfect more and more. And so the pressure does build up.
World-class opera singers spend far more time traveling than actually performing. It's an occupational hazard that Thomas Allen has come to terms with. Now at the peak of his career, it's possible to be away from his London home for up to 10 months of the year.
To Munich.
Yeah. Just the one case.
Yes.
Would you like smoking or non-smoking?
Non-smoking. I'll see if you've got one.
It can be lonely, exhausting and frustrating.
Do you know where the departure lounge is?
Yes.
Okay, if you wait upstairs, you'll call the flight at about 5 to 6.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. The so-called glamour of jet-setting seemed a long way off when Thomas Allen first started to sing. He was born and brought up in the northeast of England, a cold, rugged area of warm, gritty people who work hard when they can and who love to laugh and sing. There was music in Tom's life from the beginning. In fact, he was surrounded by it. His grandfather built an organ in the front parlor, and his father, an accomplished pianist, played in his own band, and the whole family seemed always to be singing. All round, there was the great tradition of chapel choirs and, of course, the church itself. When Tom went to Ryup Grammar School, his sights were set on a career in medicine. But it was a physics teacher and accomplished singer himself who spotted his enormous potential.
I used to take the broken-voiced choir, that is when boys had, you know, reached the age of 15 or 16, I used to get them together and teach them student songs and so on, because we used to have an annual concert. And at the time, I used to say every year, now, if any of you boys think you are good enough to sing at the concert, come and have an audition with me. But this boy came out, and gosh, I thought, this is something, you know, he's only 16, tremendous stuff. I showed him the basics, and then I persuaded him to enter one or two music festivals in the area, at which he did remarkably well. He didn't win everything, of course, but it was quite obvious that he impressed the adjudicators there, and I was quite sure that he was going to be a star.
Dennis Weatherly was right, and by way of the Welsh National Opera, Thomas Allen took the first steps towards what was to become a glittering career, and which eventually brought him to the Royal Opera House, Covent Garden, where he was to master a wide range of demanding roles. And on this occasion, he arrived to rehearse one major opera, the taxing Ulysses by Monteverdi, for the Salzburg Festival, while still performing another.
Desiato il ritorno. Yes, by all means. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, that's what you're doing on June the 26th,
or whenever it is.
Some time ago, you talked about being a child of the northeast of England and never ever losing sight of that. What does that actually mean to your performing, your music making?
I can't always bear that in mind, I think, when I'm performing. It's not always in the forefront of one's mind, because once you're there, you're just going through with it. But I think it affects behavioral patterns and relationships with people. Certainly it has something to do with that, because I think if there's a generalized northeastern characteristic, it is that there's a sort of warmth in people there, and a generosity of spirit. I can go there occasionally and sort of recharge the batteries. I think it is important still to me to get back there. It is, no question of it.
I've learned an awful lot and learned an awful lot of cultures around the world. My basic, natural, instinctive culture is that of the northeast. It's a very simple one, but it's a very rich one.
Yours, yeah.
Good finish for the first group.
Yes, it is. That's the sixth of that group, isn't it? I've just got to have that feeling that we're going right to the end. If that dotted minimum in the penultimate bar for me feels as if it's hanging about, it's frightening. I find it quite frightening.
Okay.
That worked rather well, that placing, I thought.
I still have trouble believing in myself. I think most artists are filled constantly with self-doubt. I need reassurance all the way along the line that it still works.
Let's go to the start of the program, shall we? Wirklich doch.
Tom and accompanist Roger Vinyals rehearse a program of Brahms songs for a solo recital behind the Iron Curtain in Prague. Meanwhile, preparations of a different kind are taking place 300 miles to the north in the Durham mining town of Hettenlehole.